God is with us.
And now we will be saying God Eternal.
God
was born in a cave in Bethlehem in order to fulfill the God's prophecy. Jesus, my name, can you remember? The angels sang glory to God in the highest. The wise men brought gifts of gold, and the angel Gabriel announced to Mary that she would be the Savior's mother. H stands for Herod, that wicked old king who tried to kill Jesus, a terrible thing. I stand for Isaiah, the prophet of old who's preaching the birth of the Savior foretold.
My name is Jay, and I stand for 3 Joseph, the Garden, John the Baptist, and Jesus, you see.
We'll be singing From Bethlehem again.
Jesus, dear Jesus, our treasures are gifts of pure gold we cannot offer you.
Prophets and prophecies begin with P. That's me. The prophets were sent to prepare the world for Christ, who was the fulfillment of their prophecies. Q is for quiet Christmas Eve night, with snow-covered hills glistening silvery. And we will now have Sophie sing her snowman. Tidings on earth for all men to hear, and we will be singing the second verse of God Eternal.
Christ the King, to him
I am S. I stand for the star that shone in the sky. I stand for the shepherd so solemn and shy. I stand for the Savior God sent from on high. T is my name. I bring you good tidings of great joy. I represent the Theotokos, Mary, the birth giver of God. My word is the smallest, yet it takes the whole world. My letter is U, and it stands for all of us. V is for the Virgin Mary, who gave birth to the Son of God. I am Z. Through her, I bring victory over sin. And now, the Abrahamsons, with the addition of a Tom, will be singing Silent Night.
Thank you. worship God, a witness to the world. Don't you remind us of all these things?
I am X. In Greek, my name is Kai. Together with the Greek R, called Rho, we form a symbol for Christ called the Kairo. This is me. I am important without my Y word, Christmas might not be. I'm here to remind you that Mary said yes to God, agreeing to be the mother of his son. Let's all say yes to God, too. I'm last on our list. My letter is Z, to remind you of Zechariah. You see, he's Elizabeth's husband and prophet and priest. At the end of our program for Christ's birthday feast.
And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. The census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was out of the house and lineage of David, 5 to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths lying in the manger."
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us."
And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger. Now, when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, as it was told them.
And we will be singing the Trumpet at Christmas.
Please sing along.
Yeah. Don't hesitate.
Your nativity, O Christ our God, has shown to the world the light of wisdom. For by it those who worship the stars were taught by your star to adore you, the Son of Righteousness, and to know you the Orient from on high. O Lord, glory to you.
Now please join us to sing Jingle Bells.
I like it all. St. Nicholas.
Ready for Christmas, and he couldn't get the spirit of Christmas. He didn't get any Christmas cards. So someone suggested maybe if he helped somebody. So his sister comes over and says, "Big brother, could you help me write my letter to Santa?" He says, "Oh, that should be good." It's good. So he starts writing her letter. She goes, "Dear Mr. Santa, how are you? How's Mrs. Claus and the reindeer? Are you all ready for your trip? I've been extra specially good this year, so I got a long list of clothes, and please send me everything that I have on the list, and I have it marked down the quantity and the size and color of everything I want. If that's too much for you, I'll make it easy. Just send me cash, preferably 10s and 20s. And Charlie Brown is crazy. He said, "Oh, I couldn't believe it," so he ran off. Then he sees his dog Snoopy. He thinks Snoopy would be better. There is Snoopy decorating his doghouse for the annual Decorate Your House for Christmas. So he was upset. So finally Lucy said, "Why don't you help us do the Christmas pageant they were going to do, much like you had." But they were so unorganized, they figured, "Well, maybe we get a Christmas tree." So he goes to get his tiny little tree, they put a bulb on it, and it falls over like it dies. And so Lucy and them, they're laughing at him and saying, "This is crazy." So he runs off. He's upset. At that point, his good friend Linus stands up and says, "That's not what Christmas is about. So could you please spotlight?" So the spotlight comes on him and he reads a passage that we just heard about the birth of Jesus. That in the field, there were these big shepherds. They were nice and quiet. And all of a sudden, the angels appeared to them, telling them that in the town of Bethlehem, in this little cave, was born Jesus, Christ the Savior. And they would know him by seeing this little babe in the manger wrapped in swaddling clothes. So, and then they heard the angels singing glory to God in the highest, and they were scared, but then they decided to go see it. Now the interesting thing about that is that the whole town of Bethlehem was so concerned about the taxation that they were having parties, the inns were filled, so there was no place for Joseph and Mary to stay. So that's why they had to go sleep in a cave. And so everybody was busy about doing their thing, and the shepherds were off in the mountains tending their sheep. So they had to stay awake because you couldn't sleep at night because maybe the sheep would wander off,
or worse yet, maybe a wolf or some animal would come and want to eat the sheep, so he had to be there to protect the sheep. So they're nice and quiet, sitting there praying, and all of a sudden the sky just lights up, and they get to see the angels. And the angels tell them about the good news. And that's the story for us, that like those shepherds, we need to be quiet, not like the people in Bethlehem who are partying and having a wild time, and not like in the public ground where everybody was concerned about their own little thing and what they were getting for Christmas and all that, but to be prepared. And then you would be able to hear the angels. Nobody heard in Bethlehem heard the angels except the shepherds. The King Herod didn't hear it because he was busy having his party. The people in the inns were whining and dining, so they didn't hear it, but the shepherds were quiet, so they heard the angels. That's what we need to do to prepare ourselves for Christmas. We need also to clean our hearts and our souls, so that will be the little manger, the little cave where Christ will come in on Christmas. So we have to be extra specially good, say our prayers, be good in school, pay attention on Sunday school, definitely listen to your parents. Don't fight with your brothers and sisters. Don't pull your dog or cat's tail. Take care of them. Clean your house. Clean your room. Don't ask to be told to clean it. Clean it. Make it. Because your mother is busy trying to get the house clean, trying to do all the baking. So she's got a lot to do. So try to help her. Sometimes the best way to help her is to stay out of her way. But if you can help her in some ways, you can definitely do that. And that will be able to prepare you for the joy of Christmas. Then Christmas will be extra special. Because then when Charlie Brown saw how they took all the lights off the other Snoopy's house and the garland and decorated the tree, that little scrawny looking tree was the most beautiful tree that he had ever seen. And that tree will be us, our souls, ready for Jesus. So you think you could do that? Now I'm going to ask you one question. I want to see who knows the answer. Who gave the first Christmas present? Anybody know? Between the 12 children, maybe some of the adults. Anybody know what was the first Christmas present and who gave it? Anybody know? What was the first Christmas present?
Bears.
Who gave it?
Jesus from God.
That's right. God gave the present. It was his son. And that's why we give presents in remembrance of that. And also in remembrance of the three wise men who brought gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And the shepherds who came and even brought their sheep to the baby Jesus. So you're all going to be ready now for Christmas? You're going to be good? Mommy and your daddy? And, oh, I just heard it. I have some presents for you.